Hello, this is Dr. Christy Patton-Lukes, a chemical engineering professor at Missouri S&T. In this video, we're going to be looking at using Aspen to solve a simple turbine problem. So let's go to the textbook. And the problem that we're going to be looking at is an adiabatic steady-state turbine is being designed to serve as an energy source for a small electrical generator. The inlet to the turbine is steam at 600 degrees C and 10 bar, with a mass flow rate of 2.5 kilograms per second through an inlet pipe that is 10 centimeters in diameter. The conditions at the turbine exit are 400 degrees C and 1 bar. Since the steam expands through the turbine, the outlet pipe is 2.5 centimeters in diameter. Estimate the rate at which work can be obtained from this turbine. So this problem actually incorporates some changes to kinetic energy by specifying the pipe inlet and exit. If you read through the example, you see that the change in kinetic energy actually makes very little difference to the work of the turbine. So we're going to treat this problem without dealing with the kinetic energy. So we're only going to deal with the changes in temperature and pressure and the flow rate. Now this problem, they've given us both the inlet and exit temperature and pressure, which means that it is not necessarily or probably not a ideal turbine. We're going to have to deal with turbine efficiencies in order to model this in Aspen. So let's open up our Aspen. And I've already created this file. It's the same components in the other example for the Joule-Thomson valve. And so we have water added, and we are using as our method IAPWS95, simply because that's the one that matches the steam tables the most. So let's come to our simulation. Now we're going to want to add our turbine, and you're not going to see anything that looks like a turbine listed across here. But what a turbine does is it takes in material at a high pressure and drops it to a low pressure. So it's a pressure changer. But again, you look at this and you say, none of these look like what I want. But the compressor is really the closest. I'm going to add a compressor where I'm going to be actually expanding, so the opposite of that, which gives you a hint that it will actually work as the turbine. So I have this. I am going to switch. I'm going to rename it. Okay, so I double-clicked on it and just typed in a new name. I'm going to add material streams. And I hit the little arrow there so that I can change it. So my feed is stream one. I've got the turbine. I'm going to have a product stream of stream two. I'm going to come in and specify these things. So the input stream, they said, was 600 degrees C and 10 bar. And if ever you need to change the pressure or temperature units, you can scroll through the list over here and get whatever you need. They said that the flow rate was 2.5 kilograms per second, so I want mass flow rate. I want the units to be kilograms per second, 2.5, and it's just water, so mass or mole fraction, set it equal to 1. Okay, so the stream is now specified. In other problems, you do not want to specify the outlet stream, even though they told us that we want it to have a particular temperature and pressure, okay? Instead, we're going to do this using the block. So I'll look at my turbine and the input for this. Now, this is where you first see. Compressor is the default type, but you can also switch to a turbine. And the type, I want isentropic. That's my model that will allow me to do an isentropic efficiency if it's not actually ideal. And I'm going to specify the outlet pressure. So the discharge pressure was 1 bar. They also told me the temperature is 400 degrees C, but there isn't a way for me to input that. I'm going to put in as if it is an ideal turbine. And so an isentropic efficiency here of 1, that now completes, you know, all the little blue things are checked off, and it allows me to run. And if I look at the results from stream 2, what you see is that the temperature of stream 2 is 249 degrees, and we wanted it to be 400. So clearly, that was not really the correct isentropic efficiency. So let's just try some numbers. Let's go down to 80%. Run. Look at the stream results. Now it's 321. Well, okay, I'm going in the right direction, but I'm not there yet. So let's try. We went down 20% before. Let's go down to 0.6. Run. Look at my results, 392. Oh, we're getting closer. So I think that I don't need to go down very much further this time. So let's go down to 0.59. I'm at 396. We're getting really close. I didn't mean to hit stream results on that. 0.58. Look at stream results. And at this point, I'm really, really close. I could keep changing this. The author of the textbook said that he changed it and got 0.5785 to get it to 400 degrees C. But at any rate, you see that we're very, very close. So the turbine was not as efficient as it could be, but we were able to, now we have the design for our turbine, and we can then find out what the work results are from this turbine by looking on this page here. So this concludes our example of the turbine. I'd like to thank you for your time.